when you play in a squad match, you'll have to discuss it with your teammates that who has to be the sniper, who has to use the shotgun, who has to use DMR rifle. So it absolutely depends upon the players in your team and who wants to use which gun, who has mastered which gun. So for example, if you're playing a solo match, you can go for a gun like sniper and a close range weapon like you can use an SMG or a medium range weapon like M416, other weapons like Groza from the drop. You can go for sniper plus AR, that's the difference. But if you're playing in a squad, you have to, you know, adapt to your teammates. So if one is using a sniper rifle, another one uses a shotgun, you have to use a DMR. So that, you know, you can combine well with your teammates. For long range, you can use DMRs and snipers. For short range, you can use SMGs or AKM, M416, any other gun. But then if you master recoil control, that's the whole point. If you master recoil controls, you can use all these medium range guns for long range shots too. Personally, my favorite weapon is DP. The first thing that I liked about it was its recoil control. DP's recoil control is very less. So, you know, that's the main point. I use DP because it has low recoil. Now, many people say that it has high reload time, but then I've adapted to it. I don't feel that it has a high reload time because I've been using it for so long and I've been loving it. And the damage is pretty high too. DP has a bipod and it helps you to control recoil while you are proning. So as you can see here, there's a, you know, bipod over here which you can use while you are proning. So when you prone, there it is. It helps you to control recoil in much more, you know, you can control recoil in a much more easier way. So here you can see it's nearly zero, the recoil is nearly zero. On the other hand, while you are, you know, moving around, it's a little more higher, much higher. So yeah, the bipod helps you to control recoil while you're proning. I hope you like the tips and tricks given in this video by me. If you like the video, you can drop a like and subscribe to the channel. There are three things that you need to keep in mind. One is cooking. For how long you should cook your grenade. Second thing is you need to rebound it properly. If you know where your enemy is and you are behind some cover, you need to know where to rebound the grenade. And the third thing is